Welcome back to this channel. Thank you for clicking. Today we are here with our guest. She'll introduce herself. So in this video we are going to talk about something called OCD, and this is basically unreasonable, excessive and repetitive thoughts that are unhealthy to a person, and they can lead to something we call compulsion. So we'll talk about OLD and OCD as a topic. So I'll let her introduce herself and let us in into what we're going to discuss. Welcome.
Yes, thank you, Dan. My name is Daphne. I'm a counseling psychologist. And yes, today we shall be discussing OLD. OLD in full is Obsessive Love Disorder. Obsessive Love Disorder is a mental illness that affects somebody to think that they love another person more than the healthy way it is supposed to be, or more than the required love somebody is meant to offer. So you find that someone is possessing this person like an object, and is in a love that is very obsessive. So you find that someone is trying to treat somebody like a possession or like an object, and they find themselves being very uncontrollable with their emotions, to the extent that it's really interfering with the person they claim to love, because it is excessive and it is obsessive.
So what can you say are the causes of OLD?
Well, the causes of obsessive love disorder is it is usually children that suffer from this from childhood. You find that when somebody is abused while they were still young, you find that maybe this child was not loved enough. You find that maybe this child was neglected. You find that this child was abandoned. So you find that the child is cold when it comes to the emotions of this child as they're growing up. And you find that now after they have grown up, they are obsessed with this person that they believe that they love. So the obsession grows and grows, and you find that now they want the person to become like an object or like a possession that they own. So this starts to interfere with the relationship. So yes, purely, it is usually caused by childhood experiences, which are usually harsh or brutal, or like I've said, neglect from parents or from the caregivers. You find that this child did not receive enough of it while growing up.
So, if you say that they can be mainly caused by childhood experiences, someone will then ask, what's the difference between OLD and attachment? Because when we are growing up as children, we always tend to develop attachment with the caregiver and maybe the person who is closer to us. So how then can you differentiate then if it is an issue of attachment that was not complete in childhood, or it has become now OLD? How can we differentiate? What are the symptoms?
Well, like I've said earlier, it is whereby the child is neglected, not given too much attention, is what I'm trying to say.
Yeah.
But if a child is given enough attention, it is satisfactory to them. The child will not want to have a lot of love from other people, or a lot of attention required from other people, or reassurance of the love that you would be offering to me. Yeah? So they will be wanting that constant reassurance. So that purely means that they did not get enough of it. But if you give your child all these qualities of love, they will not be in need of excessive love, or they will not want to possess others. Yeah. So that is the difference. When a child is given enough attention, enough love, they will not require too much of it when they grow up, because they will be satisfied. That feeling, that emotion is satisfied. But those who do not receive enough are the ones that tend to want to obsess over other people and possess them as an object.
That's well explained. So what are some of the behaviors that will tell that this person has obsessive love disorder?
Yes, thank you, Dan. There are so many causes, there are so many signs and symptoms that could easily be identified in this person, whether the person is assessing themselves or somebody else is trying to assess them, you'll find that the person suffering from obsessive love disorder needs constant reassurance all the time. That do you really love me? But do you really love me? You know, almost on a daily basis, somebody is writing messages. And if you do not reply, then they start to believe that maybe you don't love them. So there is a way that they have some self-doubt that maybe the love you're offering is not even enough. Even when you tell them that you love them, they say, to what extent? Would you die for me? Would you go to prison for me? Would you sacrifice everything for me? So they purely need constant reassurance. And that is one of the things that you see always coming from childhood. The child is never getting adequate love and attention. That is why they tend to want constant reassurance that you really love them and you care for them. Then also, the other signs and symptoms is they are unable to work. Gets into their day-to-day life activities or daily work. You find that you want to spend most of the time with that person you are obsessing over. You want to work maybe 3-2 hours so that you could go be with that person. You feel like you are missing out on something. You feel like they are your everything. You feel like life cannot go on without them. So you really want to possess them. So that means you try to get into their day-to-day life and day-to-day life of yours as a person too. So that means you maybe wait for them at work from maybe 10 a.m. You're waiting outside the gate. You want to go home with them or you want to spend a lot of time with them. So this becomes very unhealthy because now the person is also unable to work this love object, and also you as the sufferer or the person with the OLD, you tend to want to maybe delegate work or to want to leave work early because of that. Yeah, then also someone suffering from OLD also has issues with wanting to treat somebody like an object. You feel like you want to this something not to be a person, but you want to control it. So your sense of control becomes so high. You feel like you do not want to give the person a chance to reason or express their emotions towards something. If it is a party, you feel like you must go with them. You do not want to care about how they feel, or if they even want to go, you just purely want them to come with you. You do not give them chance to think about it. Then also somebody suffering from OLD might want to cut off friends. Find that you have met the person, let's say you are the love object and you have a lot of friends around you. This person suffering from OLD will want to cut off all your friends, will want to keep your life private with him and her own, with you and him only. He or she doesn't want you to go out to your friends, doesn't want you to have company on your own, doesn't want you to enjoy life on your own. They feel like they must do each and everything with you. And also the other sign and symptom of OLD is constant texting of messages and phone calls all the time. You find that the whole time they are calling you, the whole time they are texting you, the whole time they are asking where you are, what you are doing, what you have eaten, who you have spoken with. And the minute you do not answer these questions, it tends to really bring a very big argument or fight between the two of you. So you find that if you do not listen to all these signs and symptoms, then maybe it would actually grow and grow into manifesting to other things. Yes, so those are purely the signs and the symptoms of somebody who could be suffering from, or even more, somebody suffering from obsessive love disorder.
So when you say that they can make you cut communication or maybe cut friends, does it mean that they will make you cut all the friends off on a certain gender?
Well, they want you to cut off all gender, whether it is a female or a male. They have a delusional jealousy kind of feeling. It is delusional. That means it is not true. And it is like the jealousy level is so high. So whether you have, even if it is a child, that probably you had with another man, even if it's a biological child, they might want to put in between you and want to spend more time with you. If you have girlfriends and you are a lady, they would want to get into the way and say, let's go and hang out together, or what's the need of seeing so and so, especially where they see they are not invited. They'll always try to cut it short. So whether it is a male, whether it is a female, they will always try to sabotage it because their level of jealousy is very delusional.
What is it that is that can make someone who has OLD to be a little bit, some kind of danger to their partners? Because I learned that people with OLD tend to be, they can sometimes have, appear to be stalkish in a way. They stalk you and they can stalk maybe phone calls, they stalk text messages. They can even end up installing apps on your phones to monitor which people you talk, what you talk about when you are communicating and all that. So what can be the danger of that?
Yes. Now, in OLD, you'll find that the person who is wanting, who is very delusional when it comes to being jealous, they are so delusional about it, they want to, of course, stalk you, which is what I explained earlier. So you find that this person is sending messages all the time. And these messages are not because they love you. Firstly, they are looking for reassurance that you really love them. And secondly, they also want to know what you're doing. So they're trying to engage you the whole time. So yes, you'll find that as this grows and progresses, if not arrested, this person starts becoming now very controlling. So now, when you give him the power or her the power to control you more and more, this person now starts to even get sometimes physical. If you said we are meeting at 3 and then you have come at 7, you find he's annoyed and maybe even has broken some glasses in the house. Yeah, so that is the first sign that something worse is coming your way. And then tomorrow it could graduate to a slap because you have come home late. Or because he has seen a phone call and maybe it is a colleague and he's a man and he's calling you and he's your husband at home. So he might feel like, who is this now? Then you might get into a small argument and then he starts beating you up. And then before you know it, even you could get into some kind of house arrest, punishment. And that is a sign that you are, it is getting violent and it is getting out of hand with someone suffering from OLD.
Okay. So, we know that all conditions can be handled, and that means that OLD is not exempted. So, what are some of the solutions that can be explored to help people with OLD?
Yes. Thank you, Dan. Yes, there are so many interventions, not very many though, but yes, there is a level at which they could be intervened. The first one is to acknowledge that you have a problem, that your level of jealousy is not normal, your level of love is not normal, your level of obsession is not normal. You want to someone to be like an object to you, you want to possess that person. So acknowledging that yes, you have a problem is the first sign, is the first intervention or step that you take as a person. Then also you would have to undergo some psychological assessment from a psychologist or a psychiatrist to confirm that you could be having this obsessive love disorder, since it is under the cluster of mental illness. And then after you have been diagnosed officially with it, then now you'd have to go through stages of psychotherapy. And this means boundary building, it means self-awareness, it means self-assertiveness, it means looking out for your strengths and your weaknesses. It's a whole lot of psychotherapy steps that this person would have to take. And then if this person realizes that they are actually developing some psychosis out of all this, probably they're becoming like, they are starting to hurt this person that they love, that is that they want to possess. They are starting to hurt them, they're starting to tie them, they're starting to punish them hard. That person will definitely need to get onto some medication, and that could include some antipsychotics or mood moderators or whatever it is that the doctors would have to decide for this person. Yes. So with all this kind of support and also bringing in friends to help you, to acknowledge that you have a problem and to support you and to be there for you, and also trying to keep busy, you find that instead of you being bored, trying to distract yourself with work, distract yourself with other activities, try to talk to other people so that you also keep busy and not really obsess over one person. Try socializing. Acknowledge that you have a problem and now try to fight that problem.
So, thank you very much for that. You know that when someone has this OLD, it also means that their level of trust is somehow a little bit low. So how can we help these people develop trust from the beginning so that they can be able to maybe trust more and get back there and be able to maybe if they see their loved one leaving the house, they don't have to worry about where is he going, where is she going, or where is he going, who is he going to meet, or who is she going to meet, and what are they going to do with these people they are going to do with, because you find that this can limit the level of interactions someone might have with other people in the process of dating someone who has a problem with OLD.
Yeah, someone who is suffering from this OLD usually has issues with trust. Mm. Like I said, it all comes from childhood.
Yeah.
And usually when you're ready with this person, there's not much that other person can do to help you. It is you to help yourself and to believe in yourself.
Mm.
Psychotherapy is one of the things that would really come out and help you build your self-esteem and also to know your boundaries as a person, because now knowing that you have a problem means that now you need to set boundaries and be able to differentiate, is this the normal jealousy or is this the obsessive one? Am I being too much? Should I let this person go and work? Can I pick them in the evening? Or can I even trust them to start coming by themselves? So yes, boundary building is one of those things that would bring out also the trust to help you and to help the object or that person that you are obsessed with.
Thank you. So having said what you said, I'm very grateful for you gracing this show, and I look forward to interacting with you more in the future. And if it was not for Corona, I would have shaken your hand, so I'll just do that. So what can you say lastly to anyone viewing us from outside?
Thank you. Thank you very much, Dan. My last message would be to all fathers and mothers, that they need to arrest these issues before they get into our children. If you know you have a child out there that you think you could have neglected, that you think you could have abandoned, it's never too late. Even if they are grown up now, it's never too late, you can always go back. So give the children time, give the children love, so that such issues do not manifest, so that we can reduce on the issues of mental illness. Then if you also think that you are suffering from obsessive love disorder, you could do some research about it, be aware of it, and see how you can get help from professionals.
Okay, thank you, Daphne. It was a pleasure hosting you. And if you are viewing us from outside there, please consider subscribing, give this video a thumbs up, and share with your friends. So bye-bye, until next time.